Hello, welcome to Research and Scan. This is Masaki. Today's researcher is Dr. Fujiwara from Osaka University. Nice to meet you, Dr. Fujiwara.
Nice to meet you.
So let's start the interview. First of all, I'd like to ask you about your research team. Please explain about it.
Yeah. So here, we are interested in the protein and structure of function. So we are studying at the Institute for Protein Research in Osaka University. So we are primarily interested in the structure of protein, because structures primarily determine the function of protein. The protein have a various functions. For examples, the protein is a kind of enzyme and catalyze chemical reaction. So all the food that digested by such an enzyme, also the information obtained from the eye, those lights are converted to electric current through the protein in the eye, and also the various energies such as light energies and photosynthesis conducted by the protein and controlled by the protein. So, and also they are very important in the medical reason. All the drugs are accepted by the receptor in the human body, and then control the reaction of the human body. So if we can determine structure and obtain determine the relationship between structure and function, we can make use of such a relationship, and we can develop a new molecule that can be used for all the human life. And
what kind of method do you use?
Yeah, so there are several methods to determine structure. So one useful method is a very established method is the nuclear magnetic resonance. So nuclear magnetic resonance is a radio frequency spectroscopy, and we observe the magnetic resonance in a biological molecule in a very strong static field. That method provides us many structural parameters. For example, protein generally consists of more than 1,000 atoms, so that we can obtain a very large number of the parameters, such as internuclear distances and torsion angle with respect to a single bond. Then we can obtain the final thing. Structure.
What is the advantage of your research?
Yeah, one advantage is that the nuclear magnetic resonance can be applied to protein solution state, also obtained to in solid state, kind of solid state, such as protein in the fiber state, and also several proteins are immobilized and bind to the lipid bilayer membrane. Those molecules have a very important biological function, but the other very strong powerful method is X-ray crystallography. But that's a crystallography you cannot apply such a protein in a realistic biologically important environment. So, nuclear magnetic resonance have a unique advantage over other methods.
Thank you. Let's move to the next topic. Please tell me your future research team.
So now, now to develop biology, we need to analyze a more complex and molecule. So far, we determine the structure of a small molecule, but complex biological functions and regulation of the biological reactions are controlled by a number of protein molecules. We are also interested in interaction and how they transmit information. For to analyze such a molecular complexes, we need more information from the spectroscopy. For that purpose, we must enhance the sensitivity of the NMR. So one direction we have tried to develop is the enhancement of the signal sensitivity by using some advanced technology.
I heard you have a plan to enhance the sensitivity. Please tell me about it.
Yes, so there are several methods of NMR experiments are performed in a static field. So one method is to use a very strong static field, but it is not so practical because it is very expensive. So the other method is to use another strong magnetic interaction. For example, we observe the nuclear spin, but the electron spin is almost 1,000 times stronger magnet. So if we can make use of the electron spin and transfer the energy from the electron spin to nuclear spin, we can enhance the sensitivity by more than 1,000 times. But the well-known method, but those are not possible so far. So we are now trying to, because they are impossible because of the instruments that require an experiment at a higher static field are not available. So, but now recently that the development of the technology in the various physical sciences, we can make use of the advanced computer and also make use of advanced light source, which are not available so far. One very important light source is that generates the terahertz wave with higher power. So recently, those technology, one recently advanced technology is a terahertz, very strong, high intensity terahertz wave. Those technologies are last decade mainly used for the nuclear fusion sciences, but we can also those technologies our spectroscopy, but we need to modify those instruments. But it takes time, but need effort. But I think that is a very rewarding effort because the enhancement of the sensitivity allow us to determine the more complex and the more important molecules. Those are not possible by other techniques.
What is the most important motivation for your research?
So one thing is that your protein has a very important function, but they are not studied because of the difficulty of the analysis. But so if we develop the method, we can obtain a large piece of information on the structure that's very useful in the medical purposes. So the science is useful for the nationwide people.
Mm-hmm. And you are stressing on the importance of observation.
Yeah, so so far we have been studying on studying the nuclear magnetic resonance, and the, as the improvement of the physical technology, such as the light source or something, the NMR continued to improve. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So now I think the next step to improve the NMR is such a new light source with a higher energy. So we those technologies are very useful, not only for scientists. I think in future those technology I believe useful for biological science and also medical applications.
So you are going to improve your technique. Also the technique.
Yeah. So many people are attracted by the application, only for application, but the unique or original results only obtained by developing a new instrument that gives unique information. So we are collaborating with physicists that can develop an instrument, and also we collaborate with biologists that who are interested in biological molecules, and they know the importance of the proteins.
Thank you, Dr. Fujiwara.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Let's call it a day. See you later. Bye.